A lot of people have been asking me, how do you not lose your shit managing so many different real estate transactions and people? We're going to talk about self-management, one thing everybody's afraid to tell you about. But in order to do that, we're going to have to go to the boardroom. How do you guys always beat me here? I don't know how it works, but it always does. It's like you're defying the space-time continuum and you actually teleport over. So we're going to break everything in life down to three simple things. The first one is going to be skill set. I don't care if you're buying houses or cooking dinner. There's certain basic things you're going to need to know how to do, like how to talk to people or how to turn on a stove. The next thing is going to be the process. And this is a step-by-step approach that makes complicated things manageable. You don't figure out how to serve a meal when it ain't ready yet, but you can look at a picture down the road. You don't try to figure out how to sell a house before you have it under contract or you own it. And if you do try that, it's practicing real estate without a license. We can give you the skill set and the process in our course, Flipping Without Flopping. It's right down below here. The thing that I struggle to teach people, and this is why you would hire a coach, and it's honestly, in my opinion, something that might be best learned over your lifetime, convey this to your children at a very young age, is self-management. The only person you are stuck with the rest of your life, is you. So you might as well get to know you and train yourself so you can rely on you more than anybody else, because if you want to manage people, a team, and a business, you got to be able to manage and count on yourself more than anything. This is something that I learned growing up in business. This is something that I learned through sports. This is something that I learned through bodybuilding, which is barely actually gym participation, and it's round-the-clock lifestyle. And if you can't count on you, you can't count on anybody. There's nobody up there on stage to protect you. I read a quote a long time ago before I decided to pursue bodybuilding as a professional. Never cracked it, almost got it. First runner-up, Mr. America 2011, you can Google that. I believe it was by Ronnie Coleman, and it said, success in bodybuilding dictates success in the rest of your life. And sure enough, just about everybody I knew who did it that had a brain was successful in business because they can rely on themselves. We're going to erase this board, and we're going to break down my day so you can see the flow. And believe it or not, most of what we're going to touch on, if not all of it, is not real estate. It's taking care of yourself so you can take care of those around you. Here we go. So, I'm going to give you Chuck's system for self-management, and the first thing you might know about this board is there's actually nothing about real estate or business on it, and these are all things that I do Monday through Friday and on weekends, and there's a few things I do once a week that we'll throw in as well, just to remind me that I'm important, that I'm in control of my own life, and we're going to take you through it. So here's Chuck's system for self-management. This is something I've learned over the years. It helps me operate myself at a higher level, be more functional and more productive throughout the day. And some of you guys should really take this seriously and take notes, because the most valuable asset we have after action is time. And this is really going to save you a tremendous amount of time and make you more functional in between the little breaks. So oddly enough, and I don't tell a lot of people this, the first thing I do every morning when my alarm goes off is there's something programmed into my phone. I read a Bible verse. And I actually talk it over with one of my partners that I work out with a little bit later that day. After that, I get out of bed, go through your typical routine, brush your teeth, make coffee. 8:30 a.m., I eat breakfast. I have my meals all already prepared. I do my meal prep myself because I actually enjoy it, and it's a way for me to de-stress. I've tried a number of meal prep companies. You guys are great. Carlo, I love you. Your product is amazing. But cooking is something that keeps my hands and my mind occupied at the same time, so I'm not looking at my phone, and it actually helps me to detach. It's just calming to me, and it helps me manage something else, which helps me manage my life. So after I eat breakfast, take my vitamins. From 9:15 to 9:30, since this virus hit, one of my business partners, Linton, who you've heard about in a previous video, the same guy who programmed my phone to have the Bible verse every morning, and let's face it, the Bible is like the OG of self-help books. I'm not trying to get too Jesus-y on you, but it does help. I work out. I go ahead. There's a hardcore gym in my basement since gyms are closed. It's something that I wanted when I started making money, so I dropped a ton of coin on it, and I got everything you need there. There's dumbbells up to 90 pounds. There's a treadmill. There's a squat rack, Smith machines, all kinds of other things that I need. I figure it's an investment in myself, and being in shape is something that makes me feel really good about me, because if I look at my peer group, which is seven figures and up, every one of these fat motherfuckers my age is on their third or fourth heart attack. I have lost a number of friends over the years to gluttony and just spending money on that they didn't need to, like drugs or fast cars. And I figure I want to actually be here for as long as possible. Plus, I like to get laid, so if you're gonna have money, you might as well be physically desirable as well. And when you walk into a networking room, it's like, Christ, you gotta beat the chicks off with a stick. So after I work out, I'll go ahead, I'll take a shower. I come to the office Monday through Friday. If not, I follow the same plan on weekends. If I'm not coming in, I move on to second breakfast, and I actually eat five times a day. Sometimes I'll play with this and eat sticks. It helps me stabilize my blood sugar, and it just keeps my mood consistent and keeps me from reacting. And a lot of times it keeps me from ripping people's head off down their neck. So I don't eat just for me, I eat for you. Second breakfast, a lot of times for me, is something simple. I'll just hammer down a protein shake, a couple bananas, a tablespoon of peanut butter. It's all written out. I've actually got trainers and nutritionists that help me plan and help me make progress. Shortly after that, and in between all these things, in between my personal schedule, this is where business happens, because I've had to learn over the years to love myself and to do what I do. I had to let a lot of things go. Now I'm taking it back. I don't think you should ever let it go to begin with. Just find ways to squeeze it in and tell yourself that you're important and you love you. I know it's a very hard thing to learn. After second breakfast, we get lots of business done, comes lunch. And in between here is typically where I'll have my boardroom meetings, or even if I'm meeting with a seller in a house, I actually have a book bag that has my laptop and everything else, and all my meals with it. So I don't even have to think. Going out for lunch, ordering out, is a tremendous waste of time and a waste of money. Gordon Gekko said it best, lunch is for wimps. Honestly, I only enjoy one meal a week. That's when I cheat and eat whatever I want. The rest of the time, it's nothing more than energy and building material, okay? Hammer that down, keep moving, eat it in a meeting, eat it with a distressed seller, it doesn't matter, be you. After lunch, we move on to second lunch. And these are all spaced about 3 hours apart. Same thing, another shake, food, whatever, it's on my meal plan, I take care of it. Then we move on to dinner. Dinner's fantastic. I do my best to get home at a reasonable hour, and it doesn't always happen. And if I do, this is when I put my phone down and I actually spend some time in the kitchen talking to the ones that I love, preparing a meal, and just being me, because it helps me de-stress. And you guys should have some habits like that too. Maybe it's not cooking, but find something that's you and do it daily and remind yourself that you're important. And I really enjoy it. It's just something that speaks to my soul. And one of those weird people, I even enjoy grocery shopping, even though I can pay somebody to do it. When I do, it feels like I'm missing something from my life. Before I go to bed every night at around 11, 12 o'clock, it's not exactly set. Typically what happens is I blow a load and go to sleep, whether I'm with somebody or by myself. It's what happens, and it just seems to stabilize my mood as well. I know this is a little strange and out of the box. This may not be what you're expecting, but this is the underlying structure of every day that I live outside of business. But it happens while business is going on. It allows me to manage myself. It allows me to control the one thing I'm stuck with, me, and it helps me to function at a higher level. Plus, if you're just not wasting time going throughout your day thinking about where you're going to eat and your blood sugar spiking and dropping, you might get kind of cranky and make some irrational decisions. This has worked for me for something like 20 years. I love it. Every time I deviate from it, believe it or not, my business starts to fall apart. So it's important for me to do stuff like this to stay on track. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to smash subscribe. And if you want the skill set and process, we do have that course, Flipping Without Flopping. It's linked below. My name is Chuck Kohout. Always be closing. Bye for now.